Porsche 911. As far as sports cars go, there are few which hold such iconic status, let alone last the incredible 50 years the 911 has. This is one of the newest of the breed, the Carrera 4 Cabriolet. And what makes this car such an icon is, of course, the looks and how little they've changed over the past 50 plus years. From everything from the sloping rear end, the sloping front end, and of course that engine in the rear, but we'll get onto that engine a little later on. And going deeper into those looks, this is of course a very classic 911 look. All 911s, people will tell you, look the same. And you know, they do look very similar. To an untrained eye, they can pretty much look identical. Key differences with this generation, the 991 generation, is that it has the different rear lights, a little bit different front end. But the main differences for this generation actually are underneath. This is an all-new car, all-new aluminum components. But the biggest difference actually is the steering. All 911s previously have been hydraulic steering, but this is the first time they've put electric power steering onto it. And a lot of 911 fans, when it came out, they complained about it. They're like, oh, it's not 911 enough. But I quite like it. It's got great feel. The feedback is very responsive. It's what you'd expect from a high-end sports car. And it's very direct as well. There's very little lag in the steering, and it adds a lot to the handling experience. And actually, we will move on to the handling and combine it with the looks, because as you know, all 911s are rear engine. That's the essence of a 911. They could never change that. And that is a little bit of an issue with the weight distribution, because you have all that weight hanging over the rear wheels. And it's just, the way they've managed to combat that, helped in no small part by the four-wheel drive system on this car, is actually quite impressive. There is a hint of understeer going into the corners because there is that much more weight on the rear wheels, but you don't really notice it as much as you think you would. And you don't notice the understeer until you're going quite rapidly into corners. Overall, it's a very smooth handling experience. And I'm very much enjoying it, and it's helped along by this amazing PDK double clutch gearbox, which is so quick, and it's fantastic. Just gear change, it's just, I love it. And my favorite part about on this car though is that they have conventional paddles. The right one changes up, the left one changes down. None of those silly two-way paddles on both sides. And that adds a little bit more, because you just know what each one of your hands is doing. You don't need to worry about, oh, my right hand has to push it forward and my left hand has to pull it back, or they both do the same thing. And it adds a little less thinking and a little more driving, and I quite enjoy that. The throttle response is quite good as well. It does lag quite a bit in the early part of the rev range in lower gears, but once you get up past about 4,000 RPM, the engine noise really kicks in. And it just adds that whole experience, and this open air experience as well is fantastic. You can hear the noise. And the brakes are fine. The brakes, low speeds are a little spongy, but other than that, they're totally fine. The thing with this car is that this is not the Carrera 4S. This isn't the GTS. This is just the base, if you will, Cabriolet. So it's not a very truly dynamic driver's car. Ironically enough, it's not nearly as dynamic as the Cayman S. It's ironic because the Cayman S is the 911's baby brother, but it might be a little unfair to compare the two because this is not the S version, of course. What this is as a sports car is a fantastic cruising around, almost GT car. If you just want to go find some nice mountain roads to drive around, or drive to the mountains, or just country roads, go for a nice drive, put the roof down. It's epic, it really is, and it's very comfortable as well. I mean, the suspension's a little firm. You do notice it on some bumpier parts, but overall, it's very comfortable. You could definitely just drive in this for hours and hours. And with the convertible top, it actually goes down and goes up quite quickly. I've been in a lot of convertibles where it seems to take forever, but it does it in a pretty good amount of time. You can definitely do it at a set of lights. But going just back to the handling, because it is a convertible, handling does suffer because they've had to put more, you know, structure beams underneath to make it a little more firm so it doesn't like waggle about. But you don't really notice it that much. And again, it's so impressive the way they've dealt with all the weight issues from the convertible to the rear end. I'm very impressed with the handling. Even though it's not as dynamic as a lot of sports cars are. But it's just superb. And speaking of superb, moving on to this interior, it's a very, very, very nice place to be. You really do notice it when you get into there, this beautiful two-tone leather with the black on the dark gray. It looks fantastic. And of course, the center console right here, this wraps you in a nice driving position. And I love it. I really do like this interior. It's just, it makes you very happy to be here. It makes you happy to drive in it. And with the steering wheel as well, they haven't done what a lot of car companies have done, is put all the buttons on the steering wheel. It's just a steering wheel, it's just the paddles on it, that's it. So it just adds a little more focus to the driving experience, like what I said before with the paddles. So if you are gonna buy a 911 as a day-to-day car, there are a few concerns, chief of which being, this is advertised as a four-seater, but let's just be honest here, unless it's a toddler or a double amputee, you're not going to fit anyone in the back seat. My cameraman and myself tried to fit in the back seat and couldn't even put the seats back, and even with my very frontward driving position, so you'd have to be basically a child to fit into it. And you know what, honestly, like, you don't buy a sports car to be tremendously practical. It does have a fair amount of trunk space in the front trunk, because the engine's in the rear, obviously. You could definitely use these back seats as a nice partial shelf, though, so that's fair enough. But yeah, day-to-day, it's a comfortable car. It's very fine in traffic, especially just putting it in auto, take it off sport mode, totally fine. But it's very fun to drive, especially with the open air. Just any convertible, it adds so much more to the experience. And you could just drive this car through the mountains anywhere for hours and hours on end and still be comfortable and not want to get back surgery because of it. And that's getting more and more rare in a sports car. So I like what they've done with that. So overall, very nice car. Very fun to drive. It's a 911. What else can I say? Anyways, thank you so much for watching. We'll be back with more reviews, hopefully very shortly here. Don't forget to check us out on social media. Facebook.com/Challenge University, ChallengeUniversityShow.com, and follow me on Twitter @TheTivoShow. See you next time. Cheers.